Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello students. So after completing the Leibniz theorem, we are going to start with the numericals which are based on Leibniz theorem. So here I'll start with the first question which we will solve by using the Leibniz theorem. So here you can see that y is given as x to the power 4 cos of 3x, and we have to find out the value of nth derivative. Now guys, since the function is in the form of u into v, here to find out the nth derivative we need to use the Leibniz theorem. So on the screen you can see the Leibniz theorem. So accordingly, whenever we have two functions u and v, or both will be the functions of x, and if they are multiplying each other, then by Leibniz theorem n derivative is given by this. So guys, you can observe here that we'll require one term as u and one term as v, where we'll find out the nth derivative of u, that is the one term, or I would say the first term, and then we'll go ahead by reducing the n derivative of that u. So now in our case, there are two functions. One is x to the power 4 and cos of 3x. So now we need to see which function can give us the nth derivative. Now about x to the power 4, we can't get nth derivative, because if I try to find out the fifth derivative of x to the power 4, I'll get answer as 0. So it means x to the power 4 can't give me the nth derivative, but cos of 3x can give me the nth derivative that we have seen in the formula of nth derivative. So it means I'll make this cos of 3x as my u and this x to the power 4 as my v. So here I'll say this is u and this is my v. So therefore the nth derivative of u, so which is nothing but un, will be given by 3 to the power n cos of 3x plus n pi by 2. So guys, we have seen this formula in the formula when we did the basic formula of nth derivative. So this is a formula of nth derivative of cos of 3x. Now guys, I'll use this value in the formula. So first of all, I'll write down the formula. So nth derivative is given by yn equal to, so let's come here. So the first term is nc0. Now guys, we all know that nc0 is 1, so I'll not write this term, it is u and v. So here I'll write u n into v plus this is nc1. Now we know that nc1 is n, so this will be n, this is u of n minus 1 into v1. So plus, now we have nc2, so here it is 2. So for nc2 we know it is n into n minus 1 upon 2 factorial. Or guys, if you want to keep it as it is, then just find out the value of nc2 directly. Next, after that we will have u of n minus 2 v2 and so on. So the last term will be u vn. So guys, this is the formula of nth derivative of u, u into v. Now since our function is x to the power 4 as v, and we have considered cos of 3x as u, we'll find out the derivative of those terms. So let's start. So therefore here I'll say the yn is given by, now first term is un, so that will become, so here I've substituted the value of un. Next is v, so the value of v is x to the power 4, which will be as it is, plus we have n here. Now guys, whenever we find n derivative, we keep n as n only, so n will remain as it is. Next, u of n minus 1, so it is un is the n derivative, and that is why u of n minus 1 will be the derivative just previous to the n derivative. So to get this, what I'll do is, in the nth derivative value I will replace this n with n minus 1, so we will get 3 to the power n minus 1. So here I have replaced n with n minus 1. Then we have v1, so v1 is the first derivative of v, So here v is x to the power 4, so I'll say it is 4x cube plus, now next terms I'll write it on the next page. So next is n into n minus 1 upon 2 factorial, which will remain as it is. So here I'll say plus, next guys we have u of n minus 2. So to get this, we will replace this n with n minus 2. So we'll get next term is v2. So v2 is the derivative of v1. So v1 is 4x cube, its derivative is 12x square plus, now after this the next term will be nc3, and guys nc3 is, so this is the value of nc3. Next with nc3 we will have u of n minus 3. So what I'll do now is, here we have nth derivative of u, I've reduced it by one term, so I got u of n minus 1, then u of n minus 2, so next term would be u of n minus 3, then u of n minus 4 and so on. So I'll just reduce derivative by 1, and similarly for v, I will increase the derivative by 1. So v, after v, we got v1, v2, so for the next term I'll get v3. So here I'll say u of n minus 3 will be 3 to the power n minus 3 cos of 3x plus n minus 3 into pi by 2, then v3, that is derivative of v2, so derivative of this is 24x, then plus, we'll move it, so next term is nc4, so nc4 is, next here we'll get u of n minus 4, so that will be 3 to the power n minus 4 cos of, into the derivative of 24x, which is 24. So here I'll write it is 24. Now guys, after this I'll not take the next term. The reason is, if I take the next term, then in the next term I'm gonna get v5, that is the derivative of 24, and derivative of 24 is 0, so it means next term will be 0. So whatever that we got is the answer of the given function y, and that is the nth derivative of that y. Now what you can do more is, you may simplify the terms, like here this 24 can be cancelled with 4 factor, because 4 factor is also 24. Then here you may cancel this 3 factor, which is 6, with 24. So there are just few adjustments which you have to do, but remaining terms will remain same. So guys, this is nothing but the nth derivative of x to the power 4 cos of 3x. So I'm sure you understood how I applied the Leibniz theorem to get the nth derivative of u into v type of function. Thank you very much.